Morning, folks. Welcome to today's contest between the Reading Rockets D squad. Today is Sunday, September 27th. It's a beautiful day here at Hollingsworth Field, where the Rockets will be hosting the Wakefield Warriors. Today's captains for your game are number 72, Sean Murphy, and number 70, Brady Swanson. They're out there for the coin toss. Let's see what we get out of here. So, toss is in the air. And looks like Wakefield has won the toss and deferred, so they will be kicking off, it appears. As Reading will have an opportunity to go on offense first. Signal is correct. So when we come back to first half action here in Reading, we'll be getting the ball, and this should be a good contest here between these two squads, two rival towns. Wakefield, Reading comes into this game 0-2 with a tough loss last week to Westford, and prior to that against Lexington. But again, today is a whole different day. And let's see how this Reading D squad does on a beautiful Sunday morning. Okay, here we go. We got number 7, Brendan Lindmark, and number 3, Brian Nowicki, back deep for the Rockets. The ball is taken by number, let's see if we can get a number on that. Looks like number 21. I believe, yeah, number 21, Aiden Beckenhues. So the Rockets will take over, first down. Okay, the Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. They've got it first and 10. They are at their own 45-yard line, waiting for the chain crew to get set up so we can get underway here. Okay, first down, we've got number 7, Brendan Lindmark. He gets the ball. He's rushing forward for a few yards. Nice pickup. About 4 yards on the play. Second down. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. They've got about 6 yards to get the first down. They're on their own 49-yard line, just about to cross midfield. Let's see if they can do it here. The ball is snapped again to Lindmark. He's in pursuit. He's trying to find the first down. He's pushing ahead. He gets across midfield. Pickup of about 3 yards on the play. Third down, and about 3 to go. They come up to the line of scrimmage. See if they can muster a first down out of this. Number 10, Eamon Centrella at quarterback. It's going to be a direct snap again to Lindmark. He's got some blockers ahead of him. He's trying to push ahead. He nudges up just a little more. We're going to be fourth down, and about a yard to go for the Rockets. So let's see if they can keep the momentum and move those chains. As they come out, they run the same three-back set. Looks like they're gonna direct snap again to Lindmark. It's a bobble, and oh! All right. Well, they had a nice little drive there, but unfortunately, they were not able to get the first down on the drive, so the Warriors will take over on first down, 10 yards to go. Wakefield comes up to the line of scrimmage. They've got first down, 10 yards to go. They're inside Reading territory at the 47-yard line. They're in looks like a power eye formation. It's a pitch right, and wow, great defense, but he keeps going. Really great job. It looked to me like it could have been number 50, Jason Anderson, back there to make the stop. Did a great job of stopping him behind the scrimmage, but the running back kept his momentum, kept his feet chugging, and got a couple more yards out of it. Looks like they're trying for a reverse here. Number 3, Nowicki's in position, and he's chased down. Great play. Number 8, Rocco Masciarelli, to chase him from behind and stop him behind the line of scrimmage. Excellent play for the Rockets. And they are going almost with like a, what looks to be like a hurry-up offense here, trying to catch the Rockets off guard. With the power eye formation, it's going to be a pitch. Nice play. Oh, it's the toss pass. And oh boy, what an excellent toss by the quarterback. He had the receiver deep downfield behind the defenders. But unfortunately, just overthrew the receiver a little bit. And they're going to come up to the line of scrimmage with a fourth down. Again, they're staying in a hurry up. Nope, they're going to huddle up here. Okay. See if the defense can hold him here. They got about 7 yards to go for the first down. They need to get across the 38. Quarterback's got it. He's rushing out there. Anderson again behind him to slow up the play to allow for the rest of the Rocket defenders to get there and eventually make the stop and get a turnover on down. So as the ball has been played mostly at midfield here, but good series by both Reading and Wakefield. We're going to have first down, Rockets. The Rockets are at their own 44-yard line. There's the pitch. Again, it's to Lindmark. He's got some blockers in front of him. He's trying to get outside. He's trying to find the sideline. And he's tackled. Looks like maybe a loss of a yard on the play. He was trying to get outside, follow his blockers. He had some good blockers there, but the Wakefield defenders sniffed it out, got in there, and made a good play on defense. So second down. And about 11 to go. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. Again, they're in a what looks to be like a power eye formation. They're once again going to give it to Lindmark. He's got a great room up though. He's got a nice hole up there. Excellent job by the Reading Rocket offensive line and the host of the blockers there to give him room and get about almost about an 8-yard rush out of that play. So excellent job by the Rocket offensive line lead blockers to give Lindmark enough for close to a first down. We got about 3rd and 3. Who's that playing center? The Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage there, trying to get themselves set. Sticking with this formation. Let's see if we can get them a first down. Again, there's the snap. They've got Lindmark. He's trying to scamper ahead. Gets about a yard on the play, bringing up another fourth down. And let's see what the coaches do here. If they're gonna stick with what they've been doing or mix it up. It looks like they're gonna stick with what they've been doing here. Need 1 yard to go for the first down. There's the snap. Oh, we've got a flag. We've got a flag. It looks like we've got offsides against Wakefield. So the Reading Rockets catch a break there as they did not get to the first down marker, but the offsides is going to give them a first down. So Reading Rockets, 1st and 10. Number 70, Brady Swanson at center. He's going to snap the ball. They've got number, nice running, nice hole, great outstanding run. Rocco Mascherelli is able to truck ahead for about 5 yards on the play. He had number 72, Sean Murphy there blocking. Number 70, as I mentioned, Brady Swanson there trying to help him out. And a host of other Reading Rocket offensive linemen and backs. They're gonna bring up 2nd down. And about 5 yards to go for the first down. Eamon Santrella under center. He's going to give it. It's bobbled a little bit. But looks like number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis, did a great job. It was number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis, did a great job of holding on to the ball. There was a little bit of an exchange problem there, but the Rockets were able to keep it and bring up 3rd down. They are at the Wakefield 40. Need about 7 yards to go for the first. They're in the power eye formation. There's going to be a give to number 3, Braden Nowicki, who's powering ahead. What an outstanding job by that offensive line. They're really giving these backs a lot of room number 5, Quinn Dolan, in there also to help out, as well as number 80, Dylan Sweetser. And let's see, Rockets are going to come out to the line of scrimmage. And they're going to come with the power eye formation. Fourth down, 1 yard to go. Power eye. Going to try to plow it down. Nice tucking move by the running back. I can't really see who it was. He put his shoulder down trying to get that first down. He knew exactly where the yard marker was. See who that was? Tough to see who that was, folks. Give him credit because he did a nice job. Maybe it looked like it might have been number 6, Giacomo Iapica, for they're gonna measure this one, folks. It's that close. Okay, folks, first down. Great run. Again, I believe it was Giacomo Iapica that put his head down and charged ahead for the first down. So the Rockets have it. It's the pitch. It's given to number 8, Rocco Masciarelli. He's got some room on the outside. That offensive line is doing an outstanding job of giving them a hole. It looked like number 71, Colin Donahue, was out there, along with, as I mentioned, number 72, Sean Murphy, number 80, Dylan Sweetser, the host of backs, and it's got second down. We got second down, about 3 yards to go. Give again is to Masciarelli, who's met, unfortunately, behind the line of scrimmage. No yards on the play. It's going to bring up third down. Do you see him? Maybe just, you're not going yet. Okay, that was the end of the first period, folks. We'd like to do our first player profile of the game. It's going to be number 50, Jason Anderson. Jason's been having a great game today and a great couple games so far. Jason Anderson is a fifth grader. He's at the Killam Elementary School. His favorite food is ice cream. Great food. His favorite superhero is Iron Man. And when he's not playing football, he likes playing video games. And when he grows up, he wants to take care of animals and be a veterinarian. So that's number 50, Jason Anderson. So the Rockets come back up to the line of scrimmage. They've got third down, 3 yards to go. They're driving. They got the power eye backfield. They're going to give it again to, it looked to be number 8, Rocco Masciarelli. And yeah, it was Masciarelli. And he charges ahead for a nice first down pickup. So again, this offensive line, including number 81, Zachary Galvin, is really just allowing these backs to get some yardage down the field there. And they've got first and 10. They're on the Wakefield 20-yard line. Sticking with the power eye formation. Centrella making the calls. The pitch, it's going back out to Masciarelli. He's trying to find a hole on the left-hand side. DeWicke did a pretty good job out there of holding up that defender, but the rest of the Warrior defense was able to come in and stop Masciarelli for a yard loss. So second down. Eleven yards to go. Rockets in the power eye formation. Centrella making the calls. Ball's on the ground. He picks it up himself. Smart play. He's going to dive ahead. He's got a little bit of room. And he brings the... Nope, it went the other way. My fault there, it's backwards. So we lost a yard on the play. But nice job by Centrella to grab the ball, take a busted play, and move ahead for whatever he could on that. So third down, big third down, 12 yards to go for the Rockets. The Rockets come to the line of scrimmage in a different look this time. They're going with the two receiver set of Beckenhuis and looks like Masciarelli out there. Centrella's back deep. He's going to try to pass it. He's got a man open. Oh, he had Beckenhuis in the corner running on the flat. And it unfortunately just fell incomplete. Great attempt. I like the call. It's going to bring up fourth down and about 12. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage, determined to get this first down. Back to the power eye. Centrella making the calls. It's the pitch. He's got Mascherelli. But the Wakefield defender, there was actually three of them there that came in and were able to make the stop on that. So turnover on downs as the Rockets will now take the field on defense. Warriors come up to the line of scrimmage. They've got first down and 10. They're at their own 22-yard line. Going with the I formation. The give is to the fullback and met immediately by, looked like, Centrella, Mascherelli, Anderson. Basically, the entire Reading Rocket defensive team was out there to meet the defender for the stop, bringing up second down and 9 yards to go. They've got number 40, Jack James, in there trying to help out on the defensive line. The quarterback gives to the running back, and he's wrapped up immediately. Great play by number 71, Colin Donahue, who does an excellent job of stopping the running back for maybe about a yard gain on that play. And Wakefield's got about 6 yards to go for the first down. Number 23, Michael Olson's in there on nose tackle trying to make a difference. And the running back for Wakefield looks like he may have gotten the first down, and he did. So great job by the running back for Wakefield as they get the first down on the play. Reading will obviously try to stop them here, and Wakefield will take over first and 10 from their own 39-yard line. Your corners right now, number 33, Carter Lerner, and Brendan Lindmark. Flags on the play. Let's see what the ref is going to call here. Looked like it was a jump by the defense. And, yeah, it was. So the Rockets are a little anxious there, a little over-anxious there as they go off sides. 5 yard penalty on the play. The Warriors come up to the line of scrimmage in the power eye formation. The give, nice hit. Great hit by number 21, Beckenhuis right there on the stop. Excellent, put a shoulder down to stop the running back for some more positive yards, which could have been more positive yards. So we're gonna bring up second down, 3 yards to go for the Warriors. Wakefield comes up to the line of scrimmage. Different look this time. Nope. Yep, it is. They've got a receiver to the right and a slot to the left. It's a trap play. It looks like they're going to try to make a reverse out of it. Donahue's not fooled. He's back there, finally wrapped up by 21. Beckenhuis again on the play. And we do have a flag on the play. I'm not sure what that one was. Let's see which way this ball is going to go. In whose favor? Yep, it's against Wakefield. They're going to back them up. We have a hold on the play. So that's a 10-yard holding play against Wakefield, backing them up, remaining the second down. Say hello once again to the Reading Rocket D-Squad cheerleaders as they entertain the fans in the stands. It's always a pleasure to have them here. They do an excellent job. That is your Reading Rocket D-Squad cheerleaders. After the timeout taken by Wakefield, the Warriors come up to the line of scrimmage on second down and about 14 yards to go, and the running back is stopped after about a 2 yard gain. With the host of the Reading Rocket defensive line there to stop him. Number 54, Dylan Burpee, was in on the play, as well as number 41, Sean Crowley, was in there on the play. Third down. Crowley and Burpee coming in to make some big plays on that on that handoff by Wakefield. They're going to try to stop him again. Third down, 9 yards to go. And another flag is on the play, folks. We got a false start against Wakefield. Now that's going to back Wakefield up 5 yards and bring up about a third and 14. See if the Rockets can hold them here, folks. About 14 yards for the first down. The handoff is to the running back. And again, the Rocket defensive line is there to stop them. Excellent play by Redding to bring up a fourth down. All right, fourth down. Let's see if the Rockets are going to, the Warriors are going to punt here. It looks like they're going to throw it. They're going deep. Oh, boy. Tricky play. I like the attempt by Wakefield, but fortunately for the Rockets, the ball falls incomplete, and they will be able to take over on first down. So, first and 10, Rockets. With about 2 minutes left in the second period, the first half. It is 0-0 Rockets as they look to hopefully get in the end zone here before the time runs out on the half. The ball is dropped by Centrella, but eventually picked up. It looks like they were trying to go to number 3, Nowicki, on the play. And, nope, okay. The Rockets will retain possession. And it's second down. Come up to the line of scrimmage. Centrella, quarterback, going with the power eye formation. The give is to number, great run. Looked like maybe number 3, Braden Nowicki on the run? It was, number 3, Braden Nowicki on the play. As the Rockets move the ball ahead for about a 5 yard gain, bringing up third down. We've got a timeout on the field. Big third down here. Third and about 6 yards to go to move the chains. The Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage at their own 30-yard line. The handoff is to number 8, Mascherelli. He's got some room. He trucks ahead. Great run to find the hole. It's going to be short of the first down, bringing up fourth and one. Fourth and one to go. Let's see what the coaches call here. We've got about a minute left in the half. As the Rockets try to keep the ball chugging here, keep the momentum going. They need to get across the 27-yard line in order to pick up the first down. They're coming out with the I formation. Centrella's under center. The give is to Mascherelli. He's got some room on the outside. He's trying to go overhead. And let's see if he got enough for the first. No, unfortunately not. He didn't get enough for the first. So it's a turnover on downs as Wakefield will take over. And right before the half, we'd like to do our second player profile. It's going to be number 42, Vedant Narayan. His nickname is Vidu. He is he goes to Birch Metal School. His favorite pizza food is pizza. His favorite superhero is Batman, and when he's not playing football, he likes playing Minecraft. And when he grows up, he wants to play in the NFL as a football player. So that's number 42, Vedant Narayan. The Warriors, on first down, rush ahead for about 2 yards. It's going to bring up second down and 8 yards to go as they no longer are in their hurry-up offense. They're starting to bring him back and huddle up, so a little, maybe create a little confusion for the coaches here and the players, but nonetheless, as they try to beat the clock here, we've got maybe about 30 seconds left in the half. They go with a tight formation. This looks like a little trick play there, trying to get the Rockets fooled on that, but they are not, as number 33, Carter Leonard, gets in there to make the stop. And we've got a timeout on the field. Timeout, Wakefield. Cheerleaders doing a great job, excellent job. Third down for Wakefield. trying to move the pile ahead. Nothing doing on that play. And that's it, folks. We've got the first half wrapped up. So at the end of the first half, we have a tied scoreless game here, 0-0, the way that usually is between these two towns. They both played each other tough. They both played between, pretty much the ball was played in the middle of the field, so it looks like some conservative run plays, a couple pass plays, good all-around football, a couple penalties, but not enough to change the game. So when we come back, we'll have second half action here at Hollingsworth Field. Right, welcome back here to Hollingsworth Field as the second half is about to set to begin. This time, the Rockets will be kicking off. Number 6, Giacomo Iapica, will be doing the honors. See if he can put it down there deep. Wakefield's got 2 return men right around the 30-yard line. And wait for the signal. Here we go, second half action. Good kick, it's bouncing. Nice little bounce. And it's picked up by the Wakefield return man. Immediately hit by the special teams kickoff play, the kickoff team for the Rockets, as Wakefield will get the ball first and 10 at their own 42-yard line. As Wakefield comes up to the line of scrimmage, they're staying in their I formation. Got number 33, Carter Leonard, playing close side cornerback. It's the give to the Wakefield running back. Plows ahead for a good run, actually. Got a nice 7 or 8 yard run out of that as he moves that much closer to the first down. Second down and about 2 yards to go. Let's see if the Reading defense can stop him here. There's the pitch fake. The quarterback is trying to move. Number 71, Colin Donahue, made a great play to get behind the line of scrimmage before he's ultimately wrapped up by number 33, Carter Leonard. Quarterback did a good job, though, because he was able to get a first down out of the play and move the ball across half field as Wakefield, like I said, had moved the chains. It's important to note that number 32, Michael Bartolini, is injured today. He's going to be missed there as the Rockets obviously try to hold them here and not allow for another first down. As Wakefield goes away from the huddle up, away from the hurry up, and they're gonna instead huddle up, come up to the line of scrimmage. This time a power eye set, they've got a man in motion. The give is to the running back. He's wrapped up at the line of scrimmage. Number 71 again, Colin Donahue. He's also assisted by number 41, Sean Crowley. Number 40, Jack Janes. Number 81, Zachary Galvin was also in on the play. And we've got second down. The Rockets in a standard 5-3 defense. Give us to the running back. He marches ahead. Number 41, Sean Crowley, got his hands on him again. And the running back gets about 2 or 3 yards out of the play. Number 23, Michael Olson, is coming in on the play. Warriors line up to the line of scrimmage. Come up to the line of scrimmage. They're in a very tight formation. Quarterback's going to keep it himself. He tries to go off tackle right side, and he keeps going. He's running, finally brought down, or at least attempted grab by Giacomo Iapica over there to allow for the rest of the Rocket defenders to come in and bring him down. That was an interesting little play there. We actually lost the ball. I couldn't find it anywhere. Some trickery involved. So the Wakefield is able to move the chains. They're inside, they're right at the red zone, beginning of the red zone, the 20-yard line. First down. Damn. Okay, we're at the 20-yard line. Creeping into the red zone quarterback hands the ball off to the running back, but he's met behind the line of scrimmage by number 23, Michael Olson, on the play. It looks like he had a solo tackle on that job. He may have been assisted by number 72, Sean Murphy, on that. Probably looks like he may have, he probably was. As Wakefield brings the team up to the line of scrimmage, they're going to be in that tight formation again. Trap play they tried, not fooled at all by Musciarelli. Number 8 in there to make the stop, along with 72, Sean Murphy and company. Third down. They need the whole 10 yards here to get the first down. Wakefield's in what looks to be almost like a power T formation. Running back is trying to go outside. Musciarelli's there to stop him, along with Eamon Santrella. And looks like Beckenhuis for no gain on the play. Big fourth down here. Big fourth down. Fourth and 11. Wakefield's at the Rocket 20-yard line. They've got a man in motion. Wide receiver left. They're gonna try for the pass. He's going deep. But oh, great play by Beckenhuis. As he's able to bat the ball down. They were trying to go deep there into the far left corner of the end zone. But the Rockets were not fooled as they are able to get the turnover on down. So first and 10, Rockets. All right, Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. They're on their own 20-yard line. We have a timeout here on the field. I'm not sure. A little confusion. Nope. All right. They've got the tight formation, what they call the moose play. The ball is two. It was intended for number 7, Brendan Lindmark. But a little bobble there on the snap. So he just wisely falls on it, and second down. Come up to the play, see if they can do that again. It's the snap, it's to Lindmark. He's got some room on the outside. He rushes ahead, tries to go up the middle with it. He gets he gets the ball back to the original line of scrimmage for a third down. Nine yards to go for the first down as Wakefield is going to obviously try to stop them here. They've got the, looks like the moose right formation. It's a give again to Lindmark, who's got some room. Or at least he had a little bit of room. The blockers gave him a hole, but Wakefield covered it quickly to bring up a fourth down. And it looks like the Rockets are going to go ahead and punt this ball away. Looks like, yep, number 6, Giacomo Iapica, is going to go back there to try to kick this ball. So we've got fourth down. It's about 8 yards now, probably about 6 yards to go for the first. As Wakefield is in the return formation. Here's the snap. Great job by Iapica to take it down. It was a high snap, and he gets a hell of a kick with a good bounce. As the Wakefield return man gets a nice little return on that play. Finally brought out of bounds by number 8, Rocco Musciarelli. So we have a man down on the field. Timeout, injury timeout. It's a personal foul. Okay, so we had a penalty on the play. It looks like it was a personal foul against Wakefield, roughing the kicker, number 6, Giacomo Iapica. But as you can see, he's in good shape now. He's walking off the field under his own power. And that's good to see for number 6. Great job to get that ball down there. And we're going to have first down for the Rockets. That's, like I said, a 15-yard penalty, which is going to put the ball at the Wakefield, at the Rocket 40-yard line. As the Rockets will get another chance here on first down. Okay, first down, 10 yards to go. Rockets take it from their own 40-yard line. They've got the power eye formation, Santrella at quarterback. He's under center. The give is to number 8, Musciarelli. Tries to come off tackle left side. Gets a couple out of the rush, put his head down. Good strong run by Musciarelli, being a few yards on the play. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. Still in that power eye. The handoff is to number, great run, great hole. Uh-oh, looks like there might have been a fumble on the play. There was a fumble on the play, and the Warriors jump on the ball to get it. Tough break for the Rockets on that play, as they had the momentum, but Wakefield was able to stop it and jump on it for a first down. So, first and 10, Wakefield. Number 22, Jordan Whitmer enters the game at cornerback to try to strengthen up that left side over there. Contribute to this defense. First down, 10 yards to go. They are going to go to his side. And looks like we may have another fumble on the ball. Yes, it is. Another fumble back to back, this time in favor of the Rockets as they're able to jump on it. I could not see who caused the fumble or who jumped on it, but nonetheless, it's good enough to give the Rockets a first down at their own, what looks to be about the 46 yard line. First down, Rockets. All right, and in our final player profile of the game, we look to look at number 41, Sean Crowley. Sean is a fourth grader over at the Joshua Eaton School. His favorite food is pizza. His favorite superhero is Superman. That's one of my favorite too. When he's not playing football, he loves playing hockey. And when Sean grows up, he wants to play in the NFL. That's number 41, Sean Crowley, who's going in on to help out on the offense right now. And it's important to note that his father, Dave Crowley, is here doing the cam work today. So thank you, Dave. And let's see how your son does. So first down for the Rockets. They've got to be Musciarelli in the backfield. He's going to try to keep it himself. He's got a hole on the outside. He's got some room. Great job by that Reading Rock offensive line in those backs that gave him room. Looks like number 20, Noah Roach, was over there to help out in that blocking scheme to give Musciarelli a five-yard gain, as well as, like I mentioned, the entire offensive line. Number 54, Dylan Burpee, was there. Number 41, Sean Crowley, was there. Musciarelli's coming into the game, bringing the signals off the bench to make the call here. Number 23, Michael Olson, is in there. They're going to be this moose player to the left. They've got the blocking core backs from number 20, Noah Roach. Number 10, Eamon Santrella. Number 81, Zachary Galvin. Musciarelli keeps himself, goes to the right side, gets a yard or two out of it. It's third down. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage again in the power eye formation. Need about 7 yards to go for the first down. They're going to get the ball across the 45 to the 44 yard line for the first down. The give is to, couldn't see who that went to. Might have been Musciarelli again. Looks like it was Musciarelli. He gets about a yard on the play. Fourth down, 6 yards to go. Ball dead midfield, 50-yard line. Santrella, he's stepped back. He's looking like he wants to pass. He's got some room. He's going to keep it himself. Oh, baby. Good run. Good decision by Santrella as he looked downfield. He was looking for number 81, Galvin, down there, but Galvin was covered. No, I apologize. That was number 8 he was looking for. It looked like he was looking for number 8, Rocco Mascherelli. But there was no room there. He decided to tuck the ball himself, keep it. He was able to pick up about 4 yards on the play, so short of the first down as Wakefield will take over. First and 10. Wakefield comes up to the line of scrimmage again. They have the power eye formation going. The quarterback's under center. He gives a signal here. He gives the ball to the running back, who's met by the Rockets. Finally, number 40, Jack James in there. Number 70, Brady Swanson in there. Number 50, Jason Anderson in there. And looked like number 80, Dylan Sweets, are all to contribute to the tackle. So second down as the Warriors come up to the line of scrimmage. They've got about 5 yards to go for the first down. We've got 0-0 right now with about 7 minutes left in the game. These two teams battling it out. Pitch right to the running back. In pursuit is Giacomo Iapica, as well as number 10, Eamon Santrella, but Iapica is there to push him out of bounds, stop the clock, but the Warriors are able to pick up a first down out of that play. So first and 10, Wakefield. After Wakefield moves the chains, they're inside Rocket territory. They're at the 43 and a half yard line. There's the pass. It's up and it's, oh boy. The Rockets did a great job. Number 6, Giacomo Iapica. I'm sorry, that's number 5, Quinn Dolan. No, I'm sorry, number 6, Giacomo Iapica. Number 8, Rocco Mascherelli. Both there to bat the ball down. They were kind of trying to figure out who was going to catch it. And in the confusion, the ball dropped to the turf. But nonetheless, second down, Wakefield. Rockets trying to hold him here. High formation. We've got some movement on the line. Looked to me like it was a false start. But, yep, it was. 5 yards against Wakefield. That'll push him back to the 47-yard line for second down. Wakefield comes up to the line of scrimmage here. High snap. He's going deep. He's got a man. Wow. That wide receiver there was able to get behind the Rocket defenders, really make a good job catching that ball as he fell to the ground. That's going to give Wakefield a first down. They are at the Rocket 27-yard line. As they're continuing to drive, but these Rockets, they're not gonna quit. They're not gonna give up just yet. 0-0, about six minutes left in the game. Tight formation for Wakefield. The quarterback's gonna keep it himself off the right side. He's looking out to the corner. He's got some room. And he's able to get into the end zone for the first score of the game. As the Rocket defenders were, looks like they were caught off guard, maybe a little confusion. They couldn't see the play with that tight, kind of tricky play there that they have. But nonetheless, it results in a touchdown for the Warriors as they go up 6-0 on Reading. Oops. Wakefield comes out for the extra try. They're gonna go back to the tight formation that they like this formation. Quarterback's gonna keep it himself. But an excellent job. Number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis, in there to wrap the defender up behind the line of scrimmage and stop the play. So with about 6 minutes or so left in the game, the Rockets will get the ball back. They're down by 6. Let's hope they can get a nice return here on the special teams. Wakefield's back to kick the ball off. They do kick it off. It's directly to number 20, Noah Roach. Not sure if that was a designed play or what, but it looks like Wakefield is going to retain possession of the ball as they were able to cover because they were able to jump on it, after the kickoff. So unfortunate break there for the Rockets as they go back on defense. Wakefield takes over first and 10. All right, first down, Rockets. Wakefield. First down, Wakefield. They march ahead for maybe a half a yard gain as the Rockets are there to stop them. Second down, there's a little bit of, looks like a little bit of confusion here on the Wakefield side. They're in their tight formation, power eye, and we may have a delay of game here. It's either a delay of game or a false start. We'll wait to see what the, yep, we had a false start against Wakefield. It's gonna back them up 5 yards. So it's gonna be second and about 13 yards.
Come on now, get fired up!
All right, the Rocket defense, and these fans are getting excited here. We've got a big second down play after a false start. Wakefield with a little confusion on the play as the ball is, looks like it was almost fumbled or bumbled around down there. Timeout, Redding. Okay, folks. One of the better, bigger plays of the game is the Rockets are gonna try to stop them here. Wakefield's got third down, 15 yards to go. They need to get the ball to the Redding 43-yard line. They're in their tight formation. Coaches and refs, okay, we've got game time. Refs give the signal that everything's good to go. And the quarterback, he's got it. He's got some room on the outside. Nowicki's there to stop him. Hold him, beautiful job by number 3, Braden Nowicki, to save what could have been a first down rush. It's gonna bring up fourth down. The Wakefield coaches are gonna have a decision to make here. It's fourth down and about 5 yards to go. They did move the ball inside Rocket territory and we've got a timeout on the field. Timeout, ready. All right, another gigantic play here for the Rockets as they come to a line of scrimmage, trying to stop Wakefield on a fourth and about 5.5. Thinking Wakefield might punt, but it doesn't look like they're staying with the tight formation. Quarterback is gonna try to keep it himself. And Redding stops him on fourth down. Great job by the Rocket defensive line, as they're able to cause a change of possession. They're gonna get the ball back here. The score is 6-0, Wakefield. They're gonna have about 3 minutes left in the game to see if they can get down there and at least tie this score up. They come up to the line of scrimmage. Looks like they may go into a no huddle as well. They've got number 10, Eamon Santrella under center. They've got their power eye formation. They're gonna go with the rush. They're gonna give the ball to number 8, Mascherelli, who makes a nifty little move there to avoid the first tackler and then pick up about 5 yards after the rush. As the clock continues to run down here, second down, the Rockets are gonna go with the hurry up as time is not on their side. Second down, 5 yards to go. Power eye formation. Centrella again to Mascherelli, who's trying to follow his blockers to the outside. Picks up about a yard on the play, third down. Every down here is gonna be big, of course, and this one is one of them. Third down, 5 yards to go. Power eye. Pitch pass to the right. He's looking for some blockers. He gets enough for not quite the first down. He's gonna get about 3 yards out of the rush. As we have a timeout on the field, I believe. Yeah, we've got a timeout. I believe it's timeout ready. Okay, folks. Fourth down, 2 yards to go, about a minute left in the game. Rockets need the first. Gonna pitch it out. It's a trap play. to number 3, Nowicki. Great run by number 3, Braden Nowicki, as he's able to cross the 43-yard line and move those chains. The Reading offensive line did a great job right there to allow Nowicki to get a few yards, pick up the first down. They go with the huddle up, the hurry up. No huddle here. Chains are set. It's a pitch to Muscharelli. He's got great blocking on the outside. Nowicki was there trying to give him some room. The Wakefield defender is able to come in and stop Muscharelli after about a yard gain. About a minute and a half left in the game. They're going with the twins right. Shotgun. There's the snap. It's a good snap. Centrella's back to pass. He's going to try to go deep. He's going to tuck it himself. As the Wakefield defender is able to get in there. He looked like he was going for number... It looked like Muscharelli down there. But he wasn't comfortable with it, so he decided to keep it, tuck it himself. And go ahead for a couple yards. We've got another timeout on the field. Okay. Reading comes up to the line of scrimmage. Third down. 7 yards to go. Let's see what the coaches are going to call here. They got trips. Nope. They got twins left. It looks like they're going to try the pass again. Ball is up in the air. It's caught. It's caught. Number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis on the reception. And I don't believe it's going to give them enough for the first down. I think they're going to be about a yard and a half short. But there they go. Keeping the excitement going, that's for certain. Fourth down, about a yard and a half. There's the pitch. It's to Muscharelli, who's trying to get around. And I don't know if he got there or not. It looks like this is going to come down to the measure. They're going to want a measurement on the play, I believe. Yeah, they're going to bring the chain gang in here to measure this, so it's that close. And this could be a ball game here, folks. Let's find out. All right, they get the chains here. Let's see what this spot's going to do. And first down. Wow. That probably got a first down by the cone of the nose of that ball. So great job by the Reading Rockets to keep the drive alive. As there's probably about 50 seconds or so left in the game. They're going to take over. They've got the ball first down. They're at their own third. They're at Wakefield's 33-yard line. They're going to go with the two receiver set. Twins right. Muscharelli's going to try to air it out again. They're going for the passing attack. Ball falls incomplete. Second down. Okay, second down. 10 yards to go. Muscharelli at quarterback. He's going to try to pass it again. He's looking for his receivers. This time he's going to tuck it and go. He's got some daylight. He may have got enough for the first down. I believe he did. As I don't believe Reading has enough time. Nope, they don't have any timeouts. About 22 seconds left in the game. They're driving. Got to do something to stop the clock here. The excitement is in the air, that's for sure. That's it, folks. I believe, yeah. Yeah, that is it, folks. Time expired as the Rockets were driving down the field. So, oh, man, that was a close one. That was a close one. Very exciting game. Certainly the best game the Rockets have played this season, I believe. Good, tough effort by the Rockets. Good running all around. Good blocking by the offensive line. I thought they played great on defense. You know, one big play by Wakefield there to run it in. But otherwise, this game was very evenly matched. And the Rockets can walk off the field here with their heads high as they will go next week. I don't know. I believe it's at Chelmsford, I'm not sure. But anyways, good game by the Rockets as we wrap up here from Hollingsworth Field. Final score, 6-0 Wakefield. And have a great week.